Hey guys, it's Ryan.
And Jenna.
And if you want to check out what we're doing when we're not here on Bin's Toy Bin, go check out our channel at whatsryantrying.com.
Just when you need a little bit more Ryan.
Everybody needs a little more Ryan.
I know.
Hi everyone, it's John.
And Ryan.
And it's time for another edition of...
What's Ryan Trying?
And today we're going to be trying something that a lot of you guys have been requesting. It's Yummy Nummies.
Mini Kitchen Magic.
This week we're going to do two. We're going to do a dinner and a dessert. And for the first course, Ryan is going to be making...
What do I have here? Super tiny meal, tastes like real cheeseburger and fries. Oh, it looks like cheeseburger, fries, and some kind of drink.
And it says it's the best ever burger.
Maker. Best ever burger maker. I don't think it's going to be the best burger I've ever eaten, but maybe. But food ingredients made in the USA. So that's nice.
And for dessert, I'm going to be making Donut Delights. These little mini donuts with sprinkles and purple frosting.
They look really good on the front.
It looks like a Homer Simpson donut, doesn't it?
Oh.
Ryan's going to go first and see what's in his box.
Oh, it's taped. It says for age 6 and up, but I think it's childproof. Alright, so I've got this little tray. Oh, I've got some little tiny tools.
It's gonna be perfect for your little tiny hand.
I know. I feel like a giant. Oh, I've got a little plate, a measuring cup, which I don't know how much that is, but it's a very small amount, a spoon and a knife, and a little glass. And then I have, these must be where the food comes from. So first in the orange is the burger.
That's the burger.
Here's the cheese. Whoops, there's the cheese. Soda. Ketchup. Bun. And the fries. And then I have the directions. Remove the tray, packets, and utensils from packaging. Use scissors. Oh, there's an asterisk next to it. Any steps requiring the use of scissors and microwave should be performed by an adult.
That's why Jenna's here.
Yeah.
I'll take those.
Okay, I got these little ones. I guess they must be safer.
Step number two, open the burger packet.
So. Well, first I have to separate these things out.
Oh.
Use the scissors to cut the kitchen magic tray along the indented lines. So we need to cut out this little section and this section. Open burger 032 packet.
Okay, here's the burger packet.
In tray one, mix together 3 scoops of powder with 3 scoops of water. This is pretty complicated.
It doesn't smell that bad. It smells like... doesn't it smell like something you put in soup?
Yeah, it smells kind of like bouillon. Beef bouillon.
Okay, so we take 3 of these.
3 scoops into tray number 1. 3 scoops of water.
Okay, so we're putting number 6 and number 7?
Yeah, divide it evenly. One for you. I bet 8 and 9 are for the buns.
It doesn't look like it comes out very easy.
It doesn't. I think we're gonna have to make some more. I think we're gonna have to make some more burger to fill these things up.
Well, it says 3 scoops of each.
Well, I know, we want
it's to... gonna be like that microwave cake that we made that exploded out of the thing.
And if you want to see that, go check out whatsryantrying.com.
I don't think this is a great idea. I think that they design it this way for a reason, so that it doesn't expand out. But maybe I'm wrong.
Oh, I didn't think of it that way. I was thinking you had to fill these things up all the way.
I think this will be a lesson in why you should always follow directions. I wonder if it's going to take longer to cook now.
Now that I messed it up.
Now that you went all rogue and decided to make your own recipes.
I wanted double the burger.
Oh, it's double cheeseburger factory. All right, step 3. Open bun 0287 packet.
cheese.
That's the purple one.
There, here's bun, okay.
Ooh, this one's gonna be trickier.
Okay.
We're gonna mix these ones in tray number two.
Okay, right.
You might wanna get the hamburger out of there. Get hamburger mix in number two.
You wanna try a spoonful of hamburger?
No,
Jenna, you wanna try hamburger? Ben?
No, I'm good.
Okay.
Eat it or wear it. Oh my goodness, we get into fractions here? This is way too advanced.
Right, okay, tell me how to make the buns.
Okay, step three. So you got the bun packet open, right? You need 5 scoops of bun.
Okay.
And 3 scoops of water.
Okay, in number two.
Number two.
Wrong one?
Oh, whoops, my bad. Hey, buddy.
Good job.
Take 5 scoops of this.
Five scoops of bun and put it into number two. And then you need 3 scoops of water.
I put part of it in here.
You have the instructions, not me.
Put the other part in this one.
So the next thing is to cook it in the microwave, but I'm wondering if we ought to just hold off because this is taking a lot longer than what I think it might normally take. Because it takes 20 seconds to cook it, so I think we can wait a minute to do that.
Well, maybe it needs time to cool, like, or solidify.
It needs 1 minute to before removing the buns and burgers.
There's our burgers and buns.
You know, I thought this was going to be, you know, maybe not the best, but it's looking delicious.
Yeah, Ben is making like this.
Her mouth is watering. She's drooling behind the camera. You're going to short circuit the camera.
Would you be able to tell that those were not real hamburgers?
Yes.
Imagine if you were looking at them from far away. All right, step four, microwave the burgers and buns for 20 seconds. Allow it to cool for 1 minute before handling your burgers. Okay.
Okay, next step.
All right, number five, open the cheese packet, 028.
Here's some cheese.
In tray four, now this is gonna be tough because this is gonna be some fractions. Okay, 3 scoops of cheese.
Okay.
And then tray number four.
Four. There's one.
Ooh, it looks cheesy. It looks like macaroni and cheese. It probably is.
It smells like it. There we go.
And 1/2 of a scoop of water.
1/2 of one.
Oh, that looks perfect.
Okay.
Mix them together.
Okay. Now, I thought Ryan was going to be the one to make this, but I think we switched roles here.
Well, I'm the direction man. I'm the brains behind this.
I don't think that's enough water. Look.
It says 1/2.
I know, but
you're not Julia Child. You don't make up your own directions.
But look how powdery it still is. I think it needs a little more water.
Hey.
Look how powdery that is. Wouldn't you say that needed more water?
I don't want cheese sauce. I want a slice of cheese to be made.
All right, what do I do with this mixture? You mix it first.
That's not even mixed. Oh, that is really powdery.
I told you need more water in there.
The directions clearly say.
I'm gonna be a rebel and put in some more, just a little bit, like a little eyedropper.
All right, put some in there.
Something else sticks to the spoon. Okay, now what do I do with this cheese?
Flatten the cheese into the wax paper sheet.
What? And there's still something in that box?
This is the wax paper sheet. I thought it was just part of the packaging.
All right, so I'm supposed to take the cheese. And
flatten the cheese mixture onto the wax paper sheet in a long rectangle. Cut the cheese into 2 even pieces.
All right.
Then you're gonna need a smaller knife. And cut the cheese into 2 even pieces. Okay. But I don't know what you do with it after that. I guess you just set it aside. It's sticking.
Yes, it's very liquidy.
Because someone added too much water.
Well, it was all powder before. How could I cut the powder?
Hey, I don't know. Step seven, I guess we just leave that.
All right, we're gonna leave the cheese right there.
All right, step number seven, open the fries packet.
Oh boy.
I think it would be cheaper and easier to go into McDonald's.
And faster.
What fun is that?
Okay.
All right, what am I supposed to do?
3 scoops of the fries into number five.
3 of these, one. What does it smell like? Doesn't smell good.
That one's not bad. Yeah, I don't know what it smells like. It looks not bad, but it doesn't smell good either.
You been counting those?
Three?
Yeah, I'm on number three. Here
we go. And 4 scoops of water.
4 scoops of water. Here we go. It needs to set a little bit.
Alright, so mix them together.
Like instant mashed potatoes.
Mix them together and then flatten evenly into the bottom area of the tray.
Okay, flat. I guess I need to mix it a little more. It's a little powdery.
Don't add more water. I know you were.
No, I'm not going to add any more water to any. I'm going by the book. Okay. Yeah, it's very reminiscent of instant mashed potatoes.
Microwave the fries in tray number 3 for 15 seconds and allow to cool for 1 minute. Carefully remove the fries from the tray and cut along the indented line to separate each mini fry.
Okay, so we're gonna have to cook our food now.
All right, ketchup number 30.
Okay, we're making some ketchup now.
2.5 scoops of ketchup.
2.5 scoops, okay, there's one.
It's not red.
Well, maybe it will be when you put water in.
It probably will be.
Like that mystery Kool-Aid.
Oh yeah, I remember that.
Okay, 2.5, there we go.
And 3 scoops of water.
One.
It turned color.
Two. Oh yeah, that's looking a lot more red now. 3, okay. Now I stir it up.
Just stir it up, and then you don't have to do anything else to it. Let's make the soda.
Okay, we'll put that off the side. Sound like crystals in there. Interesting, what is that?
Oh, yeah. Oh, it's nuts.
It reminds me of iced tea.
It does a little bit. It's one of those smells that takes you back to like your childhood, you know, but I can't place where it is. But it's
not. What do you think, Ben? Reminds me of iced tea, you know, like.
Yeah, a little bit.
Like grandma.
A little,
iced
but
tea.
There's kind of like a grape smell to it, too.
And then some type of like floor cleaner. Oh, it's tacking up nicely.
Okay,
1 scoop from the soda packet, and then we fill the rest of the cup with water.
Oh,
it'd be really funny if you accidentally put the fry mix in there since it's right next to you.
Okay, 1 scoop of soda.
Mm-hmm.
A little tiny thing of soda.
Looks like beef stew.
Mix it up nicely. This is going to be just like going to the restaurant.
Oh yeah.
Next up, we got to cook our food. We kind of skipped those steps, but we're going to do it right now. And look, it even fizzes like soda.
Oh wow.
Look at that.
That's the most impressive part so far.
It even has a little fizz. I'm curious what this tastes like. Ready? A little tiny soda. Doesn't taste bad. It sort of tastes like flat. It tastes like flat soda, more or less.
It smells really bad, though. Feel.
Okay, Jenna, your turn.
Feel.
Doesn't it taste like flat soda?
Yes.
I think it tastes like floor cleaner.
Jen?
Okay, Jenna, we need you to put our burger in the microwave.
For 20 seconds, please.
20 seconds?
And can you take the fries with you as well? They're gonna go in. Yeah. Next.
That is disgusting.
It tastes like one of those, I don't know, I can't place it, but I know I've tasted it before.
It is gross, so, whatever it is.
20 and 15?
Yep. Look at those big old burgers.
They do smell like burgers.
I wanted a hearty hamburger.
Yeah. We don't want a snack, we want a meal. Smells like something.
And there's our french fries. To assemble your burger, cut each bun in half. Oh, I see. Those are each supposed to be a burger bun. I thought it was like the top and the bottom.
Oh, so you're making two burgers so that you two can both...
we can share.
And we
share
can
your soda and each have your own bun.
Well, I cut mine in half because I know that you guys want to share.
Look at that. They look like a little cupcake. It looks like your microwave cupcake. Look.
Yeah.
On a tinier scale.
Just a little bit, a little unruly, but...
Okay, there's that. Now we need the little knife.
How's that knife working out?
Might be easier if you cut them in half with your scissors.
And now we put the burgers on the bun. does look kind of burgerish.
Yeah, a little bit.
The burger to bun ratio's a little off.
I think that might be. I think that's a Whopper.
Here's the other burger. Okay.
John wanted to make a double cheeseburger just without making the patties separate.
Yep. Now we add the cheese.
Yeah, I guess let's see. Maybe
they just peel right off, like a stick of gum. Oh yeah.
It's gonna be like a cheesy spread. It's gonna be more of a spread than a slice. There you go, but you'll get the essence of cheese. My mouth is watering already.
I know, I can't wait. I've got to eat that right now.
Okay, we got the cheese.
Now we need to add the ketchup.
Okay, ketchup is right here.
It does look like strawberry jam.
There we go.
All right, now we need to get our fries out.
There we go.
Okay, now I think if we can.
It's a little powdery.
Pop these out, then we can cut them.
Still a little powdery here, I think.
So then you need to slice those up on the lines and make individual french fries out of them. Now, if you went to a restaurant downtown, you'd pay $10 a plate for that.
There you go, Ben, order up. What do you think?
Yum, that looks delicious.
Any more steps?
Step number 12, enjoy. Well, we've already enjoyed the soda. Now I guess it's time to dig into this bountiful feast.
Ketchup for the fries.
Oh, we need a little ketchup on the side, don't we?
Yeah. It says arrange your fries on a plate, your fries and burger on the plastic plate. Oh, that's arranged nicely, oh wow.
All right, here we go, look.
Very nice.
Well, you put the big burger on over here.
Don't squish my burger.
That's a bigger knife.
This isn't exactly a sharp knife. All right, here we go.
Okay, now we're in business. Okay, Ben, we're gonna eat our hamburger. Okay, there's Ryan's. Okay, look, yummy, yummy hamburger made from scratch.
Yeah, just like Mom used to make.
Mm-mm.
Doesn't smell bad.
No, not
really. It does not taste bad. I thought it was gonna be terrible.
Mmm. No, not bad at all, actually.
I could eat a few more dozen of them.
Okay.
Okay, here we go. I dipped it in my ketchup. It's not terrible. I like that there's a little bit of saltiness to it, so it, you know, kind of tastes like a french fry.
My reaction, exactly.
Yeah, it's kind of weird tasting. The burger was definitely better than the fries.
You want to wash it down?
I just have a glass of water. I'm full.
So for the size of those burgers and how long they took to eat, look at this mess that we made.
Definitely disproportional.
Well, we gotta clean this mix up because we need some dessert. We need some donuts.
I've really worked up a hunger.
I know, we could just go to Dunkin' Donuts. But where's the fun of that?
They don't make super tinies.
Yeah, this will make 10 mini donuts.
Ooh.
So let's have some dessert. Well, after we clean up this mess.